Today we're going to learn about Japanese no-tan art. This is a term which means light and dark harmony. Artists use no-tan studies to explore different arrangements of light and dark elements in a painting without having the distractions of other elements of color. This is probably the most popular no-tan symbol or artwork you've ever seen, the yin-yang. And basically the concept is the positive is equal to the negative. The white is equal to the black. That means positive space refers to the subject area of interest in artwork, like a person's face in a portrait, the object in a still life, or trees in a landscape. Negative space is the background that surrounds the positive space in the work. Here's an example of a unique work of no-tan art. The black is equal to the white, or the positive is equal to the negative. It plays a trick on your eyes because you're not really sure what's positive and what's negative. Just like the yin yang, that's the key to no-tan. We are going to make snowflakes out of our no-tan art. So we're going to use paper to cut snowflakes using the same concept to play tricks with the background and the positive snowflake. You're going to need white paper, something circular to trace, a pencil, a glue stick, and scissors, and something to glue your snowflakes onto. So I just took a blue piece of paper. A textured paper would look cool too. The first thing you have to do is cut out a few circles. You're basically gonna need three. If you wanna do less, if you wanna do more, it's okay. But trace a few different sized circles, cut them out neatly, and then you're ready for your no-tan. The first step is to fold your circle into fours, neatly folded into fours. And we are going to cut three shapes out of the rounded side. I'm gonna draw the shapes, but I don't think you should draw them because then you'll have pencil lines to worry about. But I'm gonna draw them just to show you what we're looking for. You're gonna cut out three shapes from the rounded side of this fold. See the rounded side? You're gonna cut out three shapes. When you cut them out, you have to be super neat so you don't have any scraps. The shape you cut out needs to be one whole piece of paper, and the leftover needs to be one whole piece of paper. There can't be little shavings. It has to be a really clean, neat cut. Chances are you're gonna fail a couple times you try this. So just start off simple and I think you'll be able to do it. So you're gonna cut out one simple shape and make sure there's no scraps and set that aside. Then you're gonna go to the second shape and you're again going to cut out a nice simple shape neatly so there's no scraps and set that aside. Then, when you have your stuff neatly so far, still only having three stacks of paper, you're going to cut out the third. And you should have no scraps. If you have scraps, you might as well throw the whole thing away and start over. No scraps. You need three individual shapes cut out and the whole. Now you're ready to create your no-tan snowflake. So get everything off your background paper except what you're working on and open up your snowflake base and you have a neat, unique snowflake that's about to become even cooler when you glue the no-tan pieces to it. The trick of this is to take the pieces you cut out and match them up like a puzzle to the spot where they came from. It has to be exact, so make sure you look and have it centered perfectly and you're sure that it is the piece that is fitting there. Mine were stuck together. After you have your piece and you decide how it lines up, you're going to flip it so that it lays outside of the shape. So if you look here, I'm measuring. No. Where does this piece go? There it is, a perfect match. So I'm going to flip it. So it flips like a mirror. And you're gonna do that with all the pieces. Remember, you can't just slide it over, you have to flip it. So take a moment and watch what I do here until you can understand the concept. Flip. Flip. Notice I'm not gluing right now. I'm just figuring out how this works. So before we do any gluing, let's figure out how to get this right and line it all up. And then it should look nice and neat and a very unique snowflake. Pretty cool, huh? Now for the gluing part. We're going to glue the center first. So you can just slide this all over to the side. Take your center piece, flip it over because you're going to put glue on the back, get to a clean area because you don't want to mess up your background, and neatly fill the entire paper with glue from your glue stick. After you have the background all neatly glued, you're going to stick it on, and your pieces might get messed up and moved around. It's okay because you're going to have to make sure you're in the right place. So after you have yours, glue it down nice and neat, and then you're going to take each individual piece and do the same thing you just did in arranging them. I'm going to pick up my piece and I'm going to make sure that's the right one. Yes, it is. And then I'm going to glue the top, flip it. So it's kind of like you're gluing the front of it. And when I glue it, I really lined it up to create new shapes. So now I have a blue shape and I have a white shape. So I try to line it up along the edge as neatly as I can so it's almost touching. Again, I'm going to glue the front or the top and then I'm going to flip it. Line it up neatly, creating a new space. So the shape of the blue, which would be the negative space, is one solid shape. One, two. And you're creating new shapes and a new design where the positive is equal to the negative. That's what no tan is. The white is equal to the black. In this case, mine's dark blue. And the white is equal to the dark blue. So the positive is equal to the negative. And you have a pretty cool snowflake. You're gonna repeat this with a couple other circles to create a neat design, or you can just do one. If you like this a lot, you can do it. You can color a background, do a tie-dye background, do a watercolor background, do any background you want, and then you can glue your no tan snowflakes over the background. It would look pretty cool. So that's what we're gonna do. Same thing here, I'm just doing it with a little one. I didn't even line it all up this time because once I understand how it works, I don't really need to do that. You have to make sure when you glue your snowflake on though that you leave a lot of room around it because it almost doubles in size. And I'm gonna measure each piece, make sure it goes in the right place, glue the top and then flip it and repeat until I have a neat, unique design. I can't wait to see what you guys come up with. Should be interesting. And you learned about a new Japanese style of art, no tan. Enjoy.